Over here in this very spot since 1913. So 1913. And over the years we have updated or changed the menu a bit, adding a few items. And it was very much before this building had come up that we were here. That could be 1913 to about 1960s, that when the building, the reconstruction was demolished and the new construction came up, and during that time we had given up the space to another South Indian run space. Actually, he tried it for a few years with his South Indian things, he couldn't work it, and so he gave it back to our family members, my great grandfather, to work it. And that's when my grandfather and my parents came into the picture and put the show here. So since then we have been here, and we expanded to our next branch in somewhere about 1994 in Margaon. This would be the puri for you, followed by the salad bhaji, the pav, Goan pav, patal bhaji, which is made of white grams, sukki bhaji, aloo ka bhaji, alsana, which would be a black-eyed beans, sweet buns flavored with banana, and the mirchi pakodas.
But it's not completely wrapped in.
So we call it futili, which is like the.
So it's like a way when the mirchi is slit and you see it open like this, they call futili mirchi. When it is entirely covered with a basin, they call it round mirchi.
Okay.
So people have their preference, whether they want futili or whether they want round mirchi. Yeah.
And chutney? Is it mint?
Chutney is a coconut.
Coconut chutney.
Salad bhaji is one of the tangy preparations, I would say. It doesn't have much content of coconut in it. So if anyone asks for a bhaji which is without coconut, then we tell them the salad bhaji. So it is basically the onions and the salads which is sauteed along with other ground spices. Mm-hmm. That's it.
It's very good. मतलब इसमें लाइक यू गेट दैट टैंगी टेस्ट एंड देन यू हैव माइल्ड ऑल द माइल्ड फ्लेवर्स ऑफ आलू भाजी एंड दिस वन क्या पातल भाजी द चिलीज आर रियली हॉट to get throughout the day?
Yes, except for the patal bhaji. Mm-hmm. So actually we only make it in the morning. Mm-hmm.
Can I
do
the salad also? Is there only?
Yeah.
Can I then sometimes get
covered? So sometimes by 7:30, 8 o'clock once we finish off with the second batch and the third batch, then we don't prepare it again.
So in the menu is like when we order, like what is there? So while we asking them, no, that's got over. So it's not like, keep making it like just because there are customers.
Mm-hmm.
Make it in the morning, finish, made fresh.
Mm-hmm. Fresh. So you could say the sukki bhaji is made after every half an hour.
When you say sukki bhaji, that means dried.
Yeah.
I think the best part of this food is it's very light. Right on stomach?
Yeah.
Mm. It's not heavy. Huh? And you have everything. Well, you have kidney beans, chickpeas, then mutter, mixed vegetables, everything. So kind of healthy as well. Is it tikha?
Tikha. It's like people in the morning once they come, they like to have their patal mix,
mm-hmm.
single mirchi and pav.
Mm-hmm.
That's like a thing for localites, who come in,
mm-hmm.
along with their chai.
And that's the same thing they would want to eat in the evening.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So evening they wouldn't want to go for a patal, but they would go for a tomato mix.
No, I loved everything. Everything was delicious. In fact, when I first tasted aloo bhaji, I thought it was going to be less spicy. But you can, the chilies are there, so I think that adds to the heat. And it really get that coconutty flavor and then the garlic flavor as well. So the breads were all fresh. I love the Mangalorean bun. Yeah, the sweet bun. Tell us about this place.
Okay, the business, as far as business is concerned, is the bakery started by my grandfather and in the year 1922. So that's where Mr. Baker 1922 is put together. But earlier it was called, we used to operate from our home in Baksa. Okay? The shop was at home, off the counter, just one part of the house. We used to live in the same house, we used to. The bakery was in the same house, everything unusual. And then my dad, I think it was my dad as a youngster, he opened a shop in Baksa Market, like a commercial, whereas earlier it was started in a home. And after a few years, probably we decided Panjim is a better hub or the capital city. And I think Mr. Baker is what it is because of my mom. That's my mom. Mm-hmm. She used to be the whole and soul of Mr. Baker. It is known because of her. I mean, we don't do any fancy stuff, like high-funder stuff, but I think it was her warmth and her. It was just her way of, you know, connecting with people. That,
so in 2 years, it will be 100 years of this stuff.
Yeah, we're looking forward to it. Make them separately. You have to wait for that one layer to get done and then you pour the second one. It takes like about 15, not 15, 20 or half an hour, it depends on the flavor.
It's so delicate and gelatinous.
Yeah. And some people like to have the bibimbap with vanilla ice cream.
Yeah.
They'll warm it up and then scoop up. That is bhajukka. It's also born like a tea cake. It's made of rava,
semolina
and
coconut.
Mm-hmm.
Loved it.
I think it's
I think it will go well with a cup of coffee or tea.
It's like a local tea. Like already we've made so many, bowls. It's not even like 10:45, and I think we've made
half of Goa.
And still they call it sosega. It's not true. Our culture is like this, where we meet people and we say, okay, let me have a coffee with her. And not that we are not going to meet tomorrow, we can meet tomorrow again and we might still have coffee again. Mm-hmm. But that whole thing of, true?
Yes, of course.
And what was the Sushegan? What's that?
Sushegan is a term, very on a different note, a little laid back.
I'd say Aram Singh.
Yeah, Aram Singh. Laid back. So that's why I said lazy is like ultimate, but it's more late. If you say let's meet up at 10 o'clock and even if it's 10:30, nobody gets upset, nothing happens.
We work just enough to make just that much money so that we can get our fish at home, pork, beef and we can have a drink.
Father who is not eating fish.
Who was when he came to Goa, he was a pure vegetarian, Celia Marvadi specifically. And he was a pure veg. So even when he got here, he accidentally got into the business of fisheries. Even then he would not eat. And then, when we were born and then with like neighbors and all being so good, and that is when we started learning to eat fish. I am a fish lover. I love fish.
Okay.
In fact, I have a business of this restaurant and a seafood supply also. Mm-hmm. And my dad is one of the first Marwadis who has been into this business almost for the last 30 years. Now that he is retired, but I'm taking it.
So which is your home state? Like from home where you state, migrated to Goa?
Originally we are from Rajasthan. Uh-huh. There my dad, my grandfather now they migrated to Amravati in Maharashtra. Mm. And then it's like almost 50 years plus now my dad is settled in. And now, I am born and brought up here.
So you're Goan?
More of Goan than anything else.
So at home, do you cook Marwari food or?
At home, it's pure veg.
Or pure veg?
Pure veg. We don't cook non-veg at home.
His wife doesn't...
Yeah, my wife is a pure vegetarian. She doesn't cook. Yet, she helps me with my fish business. Mm-hmm. She is the one who is totally in charge of. We are specializing with seafood. And besides that, not Indian. We have Chinese, made to Indian taste, and the tandoori. So overall a full multi-cuisine experience where one comes in and he's like fully satisfied with what is, whatever your taste palate you want to satisfy, that's how it goes on. This is Muga Gati, Prawns Kismur, Salad, Gulab Jamun in sweet, the Sol Kadhi with coconut milk, Kingfisher of fried, chapati and rice. This is the other kind of Sol Kadhi. See the difference. This is totally kokum.
So this is more of a digestive people drink. Yeah,
exactly. So we first have this with the prawn curry. And we leave little rice aside to have with
what's
the
sol
kadhi. So we don't normally drink it. The girls once will never drink it.
Sorry.
You can try this one also. This is like more of a refreshing drink.
I like it with coconut.
So let's start.
Yeah. Kaise shuru kare pehle?
Chapati and...
Can go in on chapati and then switch to rice next after that.
Or first the kingfish?
Fish also can absolutely go on.
So at some places they use breadcrumbs, in other parts I've seen here mostly rava is used. Yeah. Suji.
Your breadcrumbs would go mostly with continental preparations. Mm-hmm. Like if you have fish and chips and all those kind of things, they will give it to you with breadcrumbs.
It's really fresh and in fact good spices. Crisp.
And this is one of the most loved Goan fish, the kingfish.
Kingfish. Let's try the dry fish. Which, what kind of fish is it? Dry fish?
The dry fish?
Mm-hmm.
Prawns.
Prawns.
This is small, this thing. Mm-hmm. These are dry prawns.
Okay. Yeah. And again cooked with coconut?
Yes.
Sea prawns, palm prawns,
yes.
River prawns, and the backwater prawns. I prefer the backwater
prawns. And this one? This one?
Backwater.
बहुत ही बढ़िया. मतलब मुझे कुछ खाना अच्छा लगता है तो मैं बोलता हूँ खाना बहुत ही उम्दा है. तो खाना वाकई बहुत ही उम्दा है.
Seradura.
What is it made up of?
This, I'll want you to taste one guess. This is just two basic ingredients.
Is it cream?
Yes. This is, was introduced by the Portuguese. So Seradura, the cream and the, also called as sawdust pudding. The sawdust is basically that biscuit
crust.
Yes. And the cream along with it.